Why can't we?
Because when a trolley can cut your way, it brings you bad luck, that's why. Whoever crosses this line will get rusty on the spot.
I am not superstitious. Therefore, I shall not cross this line. I don't want to get rusty.
I don't want to get rusty either. My mom will yell at me if I come home all rusty.
Whoever wants to get rusty may go ahead. I am going back home. Coming with me, anybody? Hold on. If it goes forward, we are trapped. There'll neither be a way back nor forward.
Let's shoo it and scare it away. Shoo, shoo! It'll run back. That'll help for sure.
Yeah, but what if it runs towards us?
Then we shall bait it. I'm the best trolley trainer ever. Watch me. Trolley can come here. Good boy. Don't be scared. I'm getting something good. Don't move. I'll catch it when it comes closer. A little closer to me.
Shoo! Shoo!
Oh, no.
Well, I've been thinking, what if Sam Sparky won't catch it? So I did it.
Just look what you've done now. It's gone. We have to chase it in the forest. The jinx holds its power until the trolleykin is back. All right, we got it. Let's scatter now, one by one, and later meet in our usual place. I mean, the usual place on the road, of course.
Oh, where did it go? Oh, I think I'm gonna rest by that pretty stub over there. Ouch!
So much for the rest.
Hey, Trolleykin! Where are you, Trolleykin? Are you over there? Oh, how amazingly beautiful! The flowers are gorgeous. Oh, and they have 5 leaves, just look at that! An old belief says that if you eat up a 5-leaf flower, it brings you good luck.
I read that the nettle is not prickly for little trains. And I'm gonna check this up right now. Oh, it is prickly! Ouch, it stings so bad! Ow!
This jinx trolleykin, I'll show him. No, you won't get away from the great hunter. I shall put a delicious bait for you right over here. Ouch! Hey, you, the bad luck vectors. Catching some tan, are you? I'll get you, you jinxes. Ouch! Great time we had, I'm telling you.
Hey, what do you think you're doing over there? Oh, good job. A little train from clay you've made. Looks very natural. Take this guy in a cage to the zoo. Alrighty now. Goodbye now.
Achoo. Grandpa Billy, hold on. Tell us, do you believe in omens and jinxes?
Well, we, the old trains, don't believe in such stupid things. Neither should you, you young ones, huh? Achoo.
Do you really mean that? I've eaten the whole meadow and it was all in vain?
And I did. I fall into the swamp for nothing? These stupid beliefs only get us into trouble. I think we should invent some smart beliefs.
Sweetie, I'm sorry. I really have no time right now. I have to clean the house.
Please, Mom! Dad! Dad! Dad, hey! I wrote a novel! It's about a hero! Dad! A novel! It's about adventures!
Hey, kiddo, could you wait for just a minute? I'm just trying to adjust this small plug here.
Oh, please, Dad!
Quiet, please.
What lovely weather for astronomy this year. Listen, I wrote a book. A novel. About adventures and stuff.
True writers write novels, that's what I think anyway. They all have these long, long beards. You know that, right? And these true writers are very old, and that's because they've been learning to write novels their entire life. And they all grew so very old by the end of their careers.
Ethan, come and play with us.
No, thank you, girls. I will stand here with you.
What are all those papers in your bag?
Oh, you mean these? They're nothing, really.
Please, please tell us what they are.
Oh, please, Ethan. Just tell us already.
Well, it's, I wrote a book, you know. It's called The Frightless Hero.
Ooh, wow! That's super cool. Can you read it to us?
Well, I don't know. I'm really not a true writer.
Oh, never mind. We want to listen.
Okay, listen. It was a gloomy night. A gloomy night in the city.
It was awesome.
It was so amazing. You're a real talent.
Oh, wow. We could never write like this ever.
Do you think you will continue it? Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Is Ethan home?
He must be in his room. He's been in there all day. We're a little worried.
Tell me, is there anything urgent? Can I leave him a message, maybe?
Ethan wrote a book, a great big novel.
And he read it to us, and we were thrilled to bits.
With the novel, I mean.
And Ethan promised to write a sequel.
And so we came.
That's interesting. We'd love to hear that, really.
Oh, may I please stand here? Over here with you, if you don't mind.
Quiet, please.
The first chapter. Oh, wow. That's awesome. So many beautiful stars. George, can you tell me what this red planet is?
That's Mars.
It's my turn. It's my turn to look now. It's red indeed. Hey, George, why is Mars so red?
Because there's no water up there. Everything's dried out and turned red.
Poor little Martians. Oh, it must be very sad to live without trees and flowers.
Mom, did you know that there's no water on Mars at all? That all the Martians have dried out?
Yes, I know. You can bring them water tomorrow if you want. Good night, sweetie.
I will.
Oh dear, what a sad planet. Not a tree, not a trace of grass, and the heat.
Whoa, look, those pyramids over there look like an entire town. Whoa.
Guys, we have to explore them. After me.
That feels great. How's my kingdom doing out there? And how is it outside? Is it very hot out there?
Doing bad. The heat is 100 degrees. The rain comes only in 100 years.
And tell me, why are you so dirty, huh? And steaming like that?
I apologize, Your Majesty. I haven't washed for a long time, and I got overheated. There's no water to be found in the kingdom.
Go and chill, and go wash yourself over there. But don't waste too much of my water.
You are so kind.
Stop hissing, will you? And turn the tap off. Turn it off, I said.
The water has all dried up.
Get out!
Captain, where are we?
Well, it seems to be a very secret tunnel.
Everybody, put the invisible mode on!
No water on the surface. And a huge reservoir here in the dungeon. That's very interesting. Let's follow them.
If anybody asks, we didn't see nothing.
Aha! That's how you're wasting our precious water. How could you?
Who's there?
We are the ghosts of the desert.
No water in the kingdom, and he is watering his flowers.
Oh, no, I won't do it anymore. I'm a bit stingy, but I will do it right. I promise. I can go out and water the whole kingdom all by myself right now. Just give me a chance. I'll make it right.
Oh, look how beautiful.
All right then, guys. Our expedition was an incredible success. It's time to go home to our sweet Trans City.
Mom, we have saved the whole kingdom up there on Mars, and now it is as beautiful as our home. Well, no. There is no place like home.
George, it's time to get up.
No, can I sleep for another 15 minutes? Gotta say goodbye to my friends in my dream. I want to be polite before I wake up, Mother dear.
Get up, come on. You'll tell them goodbye tomorrow.
Oh, Mommy, must you always cliffhang my night dreams like that?
Good morning, George.
Hello there, Wendy. Where are you running to so early, huh?
I'm taking a morning run. Want to run with me?
Oh, you know, I just got up a minute ago. I don't really want to run anywhere.
Oh, please, George.
Wow, cool. I don't want to sleep anymore. Thank you so much, Wendy.
You're welcome. It's fun to run together, isn't it?
We're starting the morning exercise. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Time to get up!
2, 3, 4.
Ethan, I'm here.
Hi, guys. I'm doing my morning exercise. I heard you calling me. Where are you heading to this early?
3, 4, 1.
It's good to take a run after exercising. 4.
Well done, Wendy. I could be yawning all day long if not for her.
Thank you, Wendy.
You are welcome, Ethan. It's fun to run together, the three of us, right?
I'm still sleepy. How shall I sleep another hour? Or maybe three? Where are you running to?
Mrs. Dove, we are taking a morning run. Join us. I'm sure you'll love it.
Me? Joining you right now? Instead of getting some more sleep? Hey, guys, wait for Mrs. Dove. I'm coming. Just you wait till I catch a second wind. We'll see who's the best.
What's happening here? What?
We're taking a morning run.
What? I can't hear you.
It's a run!
What? A fire? Where? Oh! Very interesting.
Fire! We're burning! Help us!
I can't go any farther. Oh my. A fire?
Wow, what a great run it was, right?
Yeah, cool, great!
Awesome!
Well, I told you, didn't I, guys? It would be fun to run together. Oh, my goodness!
Where's the fire?
There's no fire at all. Huh? It was a regular morning run.
A fire! Fire! Help! Help! Wait, what? You mean there was no fire? We were all running. Running for nothing, huh?
No, why nothing? I actually got my second wind. Can I please run with you every single morning?
Me too.
Of course you can.
Oh, well, I'll be running with you too, then. I will.
Oh, wow, prehistoric times. It's so interesting. What is this book about? Prehistoric primitive tribes were spread around vast and wild regions. Oh! Ooh.
There. It's been a while since we've caught our last mammoth.
Yeah, I'd like some mammoth to eat with syrup.
In these prehistoric times, it was difficult to find a mammoth.
We've been out of stock with mammoths since last week. Sorry, I can't help you guys.
So it looks like we'll have to go hunt.
It was hard to hunt down a mammoth. Because they usually didn't even notice that they were being hunted.
Whoa!
Some other way. I'm tired.
There were other severities around. The hostile tribes. The tribes had to defend themselves. Was unpredictable.
Hey.
Look, the mammoth is near.
It means it's gonna rain.
Oh. Just let them invent the weather forecast already.
There was nothing much to do during the day, so mammoth hunting was the only way to fight boredom. But sometimes it was the other way around. As you see, being a prehistoric and primitive person was very, very complicated.
Aha!
Therefore, the prehistoric people invented something important, schools. At schools, they learned how to stop being primitive and become educated. Finally, they developed into really, really civilized trains. It's really great to be civilized.
Let's all sit by the fire in the evening.
Yes, let's all tell horror stories.
Oh, poor me. I washed a truck full of curtains. How would I dry them? There's a school inspection tomorrow. I'll spread them and run around to let the wind dry them up. Oh, poor me.
Look at us here. We have to get dry as well. Ooh, ooh.
It's time for horror stories. Are you ready for this?
Well, I'm out of here. Hey, where are you going, huh? All horror stories are stupid. If you've been prepared in advance, then you won't be scared.
Come on, are you scared or what?
No, I'm not scared at all.
If you're not scared, then go to the lake and come back. Do it right now and show us.
And make sure you're not afraid of ghosts.
Ghosts don't exist anyway. You'll see, I'll show you.
George, don't go too far away, please.
Watch me. I'll go to the lake and I'll come back.
George doesn't believe in horror stories. He's so boring.
Hey, listen, why should we be scared of some ghosts?
Right, we wouldn't be scared. But if we were him, of course.
Oh, nothing to be scared of. Ghosts don't exist. I know that because I'm not afraid of anything. Hallucination!
Ooh.
Ah! A ghost! Hey, what are we? Are we scared of these tents?
I've got a question, guys. Who was it that gave me such a terrible fright in the forest?
We haven't been in the forest.
Is that Mrs. Duff?
Oh, it's so cold here. Oh.
Ha!
Oh, it's so cold here, and to think that I've washed a truck full of curtains. I need to dry them up until tomorrow. That's when the school inspection comes.
Ooh. Mrs. Dove, let me help you, please.
Ghosts don't exist. They don't. They don't. Ghosts don't exist. They don't. They don't.
Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Hey, George, wake up.
My wagons.
Hey, come on. The sun is high. Hey, are you still snoring? Still snoring, yeah.
What? It's mine! What did you make me do?
Come on, don't take it so hard.
What happened to make you come so early? To scare me to death?
Mm-hmm.
Look at you, my best friend.
I couldn't wake you up. What did you dream about? Come on, tell me, huh?
Where are you going? Oh, my wagons. I was dreaming that I was the strongest in town. And I thought to myself, it's so good, it's so very good to be a train. And then you came in and ruined everything.
I didn't ruin anything. Wagons are boring. You should have dreams that you fly in, as I do.
Again?
Yes. Yes, again. And you know what? I've been thinking of becoming a plane.
You what?
I need to know what it's like to really fly, you know? For now, these mind-blowing dreams don't let me sleep a wink.
Hey, don't be silly.
Hey, George! Don't fail me! Please, I beg you! Can you think of something? You may not be the strongest train I know, but you're certainly the smartest of the trains.
The end of the trail.
No, it's not over!
You remember the theory, right?
Come on, it's easy! Clear the prop!
You remember the instructions.
I know, George! Stop bugging me! Let's do this!
What about safety rules? What about precautions? Theoretically, that is. But I've never flown myself.
I flew. I really did. But only in my dreams.
You throttle down, Ethan. You extend the flaps.
In my dreams, it was much easier, though.
Ethan, you're not a plane. You are a train. Pulling wagons is not that bad, actually.
Yes, my dear friend. I think I'm getting it now. Hey, where are you taking my wings, George, huh?
I'm taking these to the trash.
Stop. Can't you see? Even a train sometimes needs to fly high. Can I have my wings, please? See you later, my dear friend. And thank you so much for my first real flight ever.
See ya. Those train or planes, who knows what's in their mind? Mm-mm.
Oh, hey, George. Wanna come to my place and read a book together?
All right, then.
You know, I got a new book, and it's all about the Great Wizard of Puff. You see, he fulfills wishes of good little trains, even the most magical wishes.
Are you kidding me? There's no magic and no wishes of fulfillment either.
You can't just say that. Prove it.
Well, everybody knows that.
This everybody of yours know nothing, because they did not find what I have, a wish tree. And I know where it grows, George.
Where?
I know. There's one magic apple tree not far from here. It can fulfill all your wishes. Come with me. I'll show you. All you need to do is pick the magic apple. You have to say the magic words, and then your wish gets fulfilled right away, George.
What? You want us to climb the tree?
Together we will do it right. Yeah!
try to knock the apple down with this. Come on, the last attempt! Are you okay?
The Great Wizard of Puff, come and make George's wish come true.
What's that, huh?
It's the magic words.
Well, I wish there was candy rain all over the train city.
No.
What?
It's too complicated. I mean, not everyone likes candies on their roofs. Some people don't like sweets at all. You know that. Come on, wish for something else, George.
All right, fine, I see. I know. So I wish for a red wagon with a beautiful crane.
And I want my dad to come home early from work.
All right, where is my red wagon with a beautiful crane, huh?
Well, let's go look inside.
Where? Where's my crane? Where is it? Where is it? Oh, no. Ethan, we forgot to tell the wizard a date and a time. What should we do about it now?
You know, George, I think that, we should wait for tomorrow, maybe.
Ethan, look! I'm so sorry, I didn't believe you!
You see? True magic exists!
Oh, hi, Mrs. Dove. Where's the red wagon with a crane?
Ethan bought it! Where are you going?
I just wanted you to believe in magic too, George. Well, consider it a magic present then. And I'm really sorry that true magic doesn't exist.
Press to subscribe and watch the new episodes.
Ethan. It's too late. Time to go to bed.
Aw, please, Mom, please. Just let me read one more page, Mom.
The mighty hero. Hey. Are you at home, good sir?
What do you want, good lady?
Oh, good sir, there has been a great disaster.
What, was a barn burnt out again?
No, not a barn. The three-headed fire dragon has eaten all the harvest.
I see now. Wait, let me go ask my mom if I can go fight the dragon right now. Yes, get on your way, good lady. I'll go and bring two fellow heroes with me as soon as I can. After all, we're called the Three Mighty Heroes.
Quite a big dragon this one is. Let's strike him with a club while he's asleep. Maybe he'll fly away in fear.
Who is going to strike with a club then?
Oh, well, we woke him up and now we'll have to fight him.
Hey, dragon, come face us in a fight. We'll have no mercy for you.
No mercy.
And who are you exactly? Listen, I really can't see you well at all.
We are the Three Mighty Heroes.
Hey,
actually, we are two heroes and one heroine.
Oh, hi, guys. I'm here.
Oh, look, it's him. He ate everything while we were asleep.
Don't bother whispering. I can hear everything.
Hey, are you spitting on us or what? What?
Oh, help, a fire!
Take that! Oh, it hurts! Take that!
Well, all right then, I guess we'll be going. Have a great weekend!
Dragons say to each other, make friends, make friends, never, never break friends.
Okay, then. The dragon is taken care of. Let's go and give a ticket to the witch for polluting.
That's true. Hey, guys. Have any of you seen the golden fish around here? Well, she owes me one thing.
Aha! Here's a poacher, guys. Take charge of him. Come on.
Oh, look there. Cinderella is right behind you.
What? Where? Where? Where's Cinderella?
What a fraud he was, guys. Who could expect this from a graybeard?
Little cabin, could you turn your face to us? Your back is to the forest.
Oh, dear, but this is my face. I just don't look so good today. I've got the flu.
Forest witch, come out and surrender. You can't hide away from us. We can see your wooden legs stretching out of the window.
Oh, dearie me. She doesn't live here anymore. She moved out yesterday, actually. Achoo! It isn't the witch's leg, it's Pinocchio's leg. He's living here now instead of her.
Oh, dear, no, we're late again.
It must be Sleeping Beauty sleeping. Let's wake her up, because with her snoring, she won't let anybody else sleep for a long time. Who is the Sleeping Beauty here?
I'll show you the Sleeping Beauty.
Who would have known it was a giant? They all snore alike anyway.
Qua, qua.
Hey, that's my arrow. I've been looking all over for it. Do you speak froggies? How can I tell her? Why is she winking at me? My dearest, qua, qua. His arrow, qua, qua, is mine. Thank you so much, qua, qua.
Oh, my Prince Charming, my beloved fiancé.
Hey, I want a fair princess, too. Ethan, Ethan, are you asleep? Ethan!
Tell me, are you asleep, sweetie?
Oh, where is my fair princess?
Oh!
What a great present you've got, George. You're so lucky.
Yeah, I love it, too, Ethan.
It's been a long time since I got a present.
Oh, look up!
Everybody, look at me! Look at my red balloon!
What a beautiful balloon Ethan got!
Yeah, very beautiful.
I think everybody saw my balloon, and everybody liked it.
You know, I've been thinking, why do you think this balloon is yours? Maybe somebody's lost it. You have to give it back then. Excuse me, did you lose a balloon by any chance?
Oh, no. Ethan, we thought it was yours.
Well, I thought so too, actually. But what if it was lost and I found it by accident, you know? Have you lost this, maybe?
We've been through the whole town asking everyone. But what if it came here from another town? What if someone there is looking for it and crying bitterly? We have to go there and find out.
You can go there if you want to.
Hi, sweetie. You know, I had a surprise for you, but it's gone. I'm so sorry.
Let me guess, you bought a red balloon, and it flew away.
But how did you know that? Did you find it?
Don't lose it. Don't lose it. Oh, please, just don't lose it. It was my mom who lost the balloon. She wanted to give me a present. Where is it now, huh?
It caught on a tree, then it came off and flew away. I looked for it everywhere, but it was gone.
I told you in the first place it was mine.
I'm sorry.
Well, you've got your present, and I don't. All because of you.
Ethan, wait a second.
Maybe just one day it'll come back.
Ethan, don't cry. These are all for you. Do you like them?
Yes, they're great.
But you need to make up with George. You can have many balloons, but only one true friend. Now go and talk to him.
Well, it was an accident. I didn't know. And now I lost my best friend.
You didn't.
Huh?
Hey there. You can choose any balloon you like, George.
Wow, wow. Are they all yours?
Ours. Hey, George! Are you coming to play? Hey, George!
Poor George.
George got an electric shock.
Scary, isn't it? This is my new invention. It's called George 2000. He's my twin robot. He will do the house cleaning for me.
Oh, George, you're a genius.
How do you manipulate him?
With a remote. Just see this. George is good for nothing. Sorry, wrong button. Here, George is the most hardworking little train in the world.
I think the first phrase was a bit more accurate.
So you wanted to play outside?
Uh-huh.
Okay, George, house cleaning mode. Okay, let's go now.
Well, well. The great Professor George. He created something special, a robot.
Good afternoon.
What is going on here, eh?
Can I water the flowers, please?
Head watering flowers is a very serious business. But I see you are a very responsible little train. Why don't you go on and do it? And in the meantime, I will take a nap. And I can really use one. What's going on now? What have you done?
Grandpa Billy, I brought you some cakes.
Grandpa Billy, what's going on here?
Who's disturbing that peace here?
It's George. It's George. It's all his fault, I tell you.
Well, well. Where is this naughty kid, then?
There he is. Stop him now.
Dear me, they're identical. Now tell me who made the mess in Grandpa Billy's garden.
It was all my twin robot. Honestly, it's not my fault at all. No, he is my twin robot. Liar, you are the twin. I am George.
No, I am George.
No, I am.
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 I am.
No, I am.
It's me.
No, I am.
Oh, sorry. Did you drop this? Run! Oh, George. What have you done now?
I know for sure, guys. I guess I have to clean my room by myself.
Hey, friends! Press to subscribe and watch the new episodes.
Oh, Ethan, don't do that. You shouldn't take refuge from a thunderstorm under a tree. It could get struck by lightning.
But if you run in an open field, you could get struck yourself.
Listen, it would be better if we run into the valley, or if we go home instead, Ethan.
What's wrong with him?
It got struck by lightning and turned wild.
Oh, a thunderstorm is coming on. Close the windows and be very, very careful. George, Ethan, are you okay? You shouldn't be afraid of storms. You should just go home.
We're not afraid of storms. We're simply afraid of a wild trolleykin.
I don't know how to say this, but I've got trolleykin phobia. I'm not afraid of domestic trolleykins, but the wild ones, they really scare me. I can't help it. I am so sorry. It's no good. This trolleykin has gone wild. We need to get hold of it.
What about your trolleykin phobia?
A true policeman is not a policeman who is afraid, but one who is scared to be afraid.
That's true. Well said. We have to remember that for later.
All citizens of Train City, we need your help immediately.
Trolleykin stay wild forever.
Only a miracle can save us now.
That's a good trolleykin. It's nice to see you not wild anymore.
Well, it was more fun when T. Trolleykin was wild.
Oh no, guys. It's good that wild trolleykin turned back to normal.
All right, let's all go home now. There's another thunderstorm coming. Huh? Well, it looks like our trolleykin friend has gone wild again. I guess we're gonna have to help him, guys.
Breathen, me Big Go is calling you. Advance towards me, Strong Sue. And you come over here, Small T.
Why are you calling yourself big and choose to call me small?
Okay, let it be Big T. Advance towards me.
I'd rather be called something like T the Greatest. But Big T is just fine.
Me Brethren. Excuse me. Me faithful Brethren. Indian trains from the Sam Sparky tribe have kidnapped our sister Vera.
We shall seek revenge.
The Small, the greatest warrior, has captured you. Cry out for help.
Hey, somebody, help me. Save me, please. Help me out of these boyish, stupid games. Let me do some serious stuff. For example, embroidery.
They will hear Vera's voice for sure, come to save her and fall into my traps.
Listen, when we kidnap Vera back, they will chase us for sure, and then they will fall into our traps.
Great plan, George.
And a heavy one, too.
Vera. We have come to save you.
You've been playing for 3 days. I'm really bored. I'm going to do my embroidery.
If we want to set her free, we're going to need her to be captured again.
What happened? How could you forget where you digged your own pits?
Vera, wait! We have to save you, wait! Hey, George, look, I got her!
Or did they get me?
Oh, come on. How could you forget about your own traps? That's ridiculous.
Hey, boys, need any help from me?
Yes, we do. Vera, save us, please.
All right, then. I will save you, but on one condition.
I'd rather be sitting in the trap.
Vera, enough, please.
We've been playing Indians for 3 days. You'll be doing embroidery. It's so exciting, you guys.
It was a really, really dark black night, and a dark black train was sweeping through the really, really dark black streets.
Why are you sitting in the dark, everyone?
We're getting scared.
What? But what?
Nothing. Just telling stories.
No more stories for tonight. It's too late. It's time to go to sleep now.
Oh, no. Right in the middle of the mystery.
Oh, never mind. Tomorrow is a new day to tell new stories.
Hello, Ethan. Did you sleep well at night?
Hi there, George. No, not really. I saw horrors all night long and they kept me awake.
Me too. I saw horrors as well. All because of Sam Sparky and all those horror stories.
Oh, hey there, little kids. Didn't sleep tight as always, huh? What, running to your mommies to hide away, are you?
No!
No way!
I don't believe you. See you around, sissies.
Hi there, Vera.
Hi there, Ethan.
Listen, I have an important question to ask.
Tell me what happened, Ethan.
No, nothing. Don't get worried. Do you know what the fear is scared of?
Did you sleep with the lights on, too?
Worse, in my parents' bedroom.
Oh, my goodness. How can we possibly deal with the fear?
We need to scare it away.
But how?
Well, I don't know. Let's figure out something.
Well, maybe do you think a huge loco jumbo puff could scare it away?
Yeah? But what's scary about this loco jumbo puff thing?
It's huge, it's puffing, and really scary.
No way. I can puff and clutter my wheels anytime I like. Would you be afraid of me if I did that, Vera?
That's so funny.
Vera, you're a genius. And do you know why?
Why, Ethan?
You found the way to scare the fear off for sure. The fear should be afraid of laughter. I'm sure of it. Who are you?
I am your fear. I've come here to scare you. Look how horrifying I am.
You're not horrifying at all.
Oh, really? Is that so? Well, roar, roar, roar. Is that better?
No. No, don't even try it.
But why not?
Because you have a terribly long green trunk.
What? What have you done to me?
And just look at you. You have long orange ears. Such a funny fear wouldn't scare anyone ever in the whole world.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm going to show you how horrifying I can be.
You don't scare me, huh? Fear indeed.
Good morning, help me please. I just imagine my Sam Sparky suddenly has a fear of the dark. He's been sleeping in a closet for 2 nights now. I don't know what to do.
Oh dear, poor kid.
Oh, hi there. Send Sam Sparky to me and I will teach him to overcome all of his fears because now I know how to scare the fear all by myself.
Hey friends, press to subscribe and watch the new episodes.
An extraordinary event is coming next month. A giant comet will fly in space between our train city and the moon.
Wow, a comet! We must go and welcome it, guys. I think I have an idea.
George, are you sure we have enough soap for a long flight?
Our soap engine produces 1,000 bubbles a second at the least. The comet is at a distance of 150 million bubbles. What's your school math grade anyway? Start the main soap engine. And start!
Just look. Look at how beautiful it is out there.
These countless stars. What is this lovely blue planet? Is it Earth?
Yes. And there is our train city, guys. It's right over there.
Oh, where in the world is Ethan?
I'm here, hanging. Hovering.
Be very careful in a gravity-free state.
Attention, please. We're approaching the comet.
Everybody,
attention,
take
please.
Your seats. We're landing
we're
on the comet.
We're approaching the comet.
Well, everybody, welcome to the comet.
It doesn't seem welcoming at all.
A cool place, if you ask me. It's really cool.
Be careful, Ethan. Space winds may sweep you away.
Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa! Whoa! Will I ever stop tossing and turning today? I'm sick to my stomach. Whoa, what a funny space dream I'm having.
We are happy to welcome you to our comet, alien.
Welcome to your comet? Is it real then? Wait, why do we look alike? Are we relatives?
We always take a shape of an object we see for the first time. And this is the first time we see you.
Awesome!
We'll split into three groups and look for Ethan. I'll start by...
Hey, look, guys! I'm here!
Didn't you mean we are here? Ethan, enough with your tricks.
These funny comet aliens. Did you see them?
Yeah, they took the shape of our tank wagon.
George, what did you give them as a souvenir? I gave them soap. They've never seen it before, ever.
All hail soap. Ouch. Ouch.
Hello, my friends. Let's ride together. We will be best friends forever. Look, an exciting road awaits us. So no, oh no, don't stop. No, don't wait, no, let's go. Let's move, we're going very fast now. Faster, what a blast. And while together we'll have so much fun each day. We'll learn, we'll sing, we'll dream, we'll go.
Press to subscribe and watch the new episodes.